Everything's changed around here since the yuppies moved in.
Need a brightening up.
You're brightening up, not taking over.
Hello, you're with the police officers.
I'm DS Taylor, this is DC Carver. You're the owner.
That's right, Paul Layton.
The alarm went about 2 this morning. The police came round to my home shortly afterwards. This is Kay. She works here. Sorry, I've forgotten your names.
I'm DS Daly, this is DC Carver.
Because as you can see, the burglar got in through the front door. Your officers didn't seem to think it was a very professional job. Whoever it was just grabbed what he could. Any idea what's missing?
This is a list of the stolen items and breakages.
Kay's very efficient.
Some silverware, porcelain, not the best pieces. But he did take some jewellery.
Oh, yes, we had some, what was it?
Zahazi. Are you familiar with Zahazi?
Can't say I am. Is it valuable?
Kay's the expert.
At one time, he was jeweller to the Austrian court.
Is that right?
This woman came in a couple of weeks ago with some of her mother's jewellery. The old lady had just died. Kay recognised its worth immediately.
I can't imagine the burglar has any idea what he's got.
Probably give it to his girlfriend. Some low-life tarts wandering around with 7 grand's worth of jewellery around her neck.
It's so distinctive. There must be a chance the pieces will turn up.
Well, we'll enter the details onto our database.
That I look sore.
Would you believe it? I walked into a door.
Obviously, it'll take you a while to settle in, Tom. Everyone's a bit snowed under at the moment.
No, I want to get stuck in, Gov.
Did you bring any stouts with you?
Yeah. One or two hang out in this area. They're pretty reliable.
Good.
Tell me, you got much of a crack bomb on your ground?
Not today.
I think you might have soon. One of my snouts is Mickey Snell. He's got a crack habit. If he's moved to this patch, it's because there's a good source of supply.
Well, keep us up to date.
Yeah, I will.
Right, let's show your face.
I hope you don't mind, Gov. I took the liberty of introducing myself to some of the uniforms earlier.
No, no, not at all. We've got a little relationship on the whole.
Well, I'm not long out of uniform myself. It's nothing like walking the beat to get to know a place. I'm starting to get a picture of Sunil.
Jeff, this is DC Tom Proctor, just joined us from Haringey, DS Daly.
Welcome to the Madhouse.
Jim Carver.
Haringey. Do you know Kevin McKenna?
Yeah, Kev's a good pal.
Yeah, we were at Hendon together. Excuse me.
Let's see who's down in the canteen.
CID, Jim Carver. Yeah, thanks. Sarge, Kay Fox is downstairs. She's got some info about the burglary.
Can you deal with it? I've got a meeting with the DCI.
Sure.
You won't mind handling Miss Fox on your own, will you?
I've just come from the arcade in Rampling Yard.
The antiques market?
I saw my ex-boyfriend there.
So what's the significance?
He's just got out of prison. For burglary.
What's his name?
Len. Len Murray.
I don't know.
You wouldn't. This wasn't his patch. He used to live up in Dalston. I hadn't seen him for over a year. Then he turned up out of the blue about 3 weeks ago. He's been hanging around, hoping we'd get back together. I told him there was no chance of that. But some men won't take no for an answer.
Is he responsible for that eye?
He followed me one day and found out where I worked. He was checking everything out, asking the value of things. He seemed particularly interested in the jewellery.
Why didn't you tell me this earlier?
I didn't want to make trouble for him. I don't know that he broke in, but he doesn't know anything about antiques. So what's he doing down the arcade?
Could he give me a description?
29. A big bloke. Cropped hair. Looks as though he needs a shave.
He doesn't sound like your type.
He isn't. Never was, really. He was at the market just 15 minutes ago. He'll probably still be there.
Must have missed him.
She gave me an address for him. 39 Waterman's Road.
Let's ask around the stallholders first. See if anyone fitting Len's description has been trying to flog anything off.
Sarge.
Excuse me, sir. DS Daly, DC Carver, Sunil Police Station. Mind if we ask you a few questions?
What about?
You tell us what you've got in the bag.
Why?
We're just making some inquiries.
Aye! Hey!
No need for that.
Yep. These are all from the shop. How about the jewellery?
There was no jewellery in the bag when we caught him. We've searched his bedsit, there's no sign of it there. Maybe he sold it on already.
Well, lucky that Kay spotted him.
Did you know that Len had been hanging around her?
Well, she told me that an old boyfriend had been harassing her. I said to call the police. She wouldn't know.
He's not the kind of man I would have pictured as Kay's boyfriend.
I don't know much about her background. But I gather she's, from the wrong side of the tracks. You wouldn't think it, though.
How long's she been working for you?
About 6 months. She'd come into the shop to try and sell bits and pieces that she'd picked up at junk shops, boot sales. I got to know her a bit. She's been a godsend, really. I don't know much about antiques.
No?
Yeah, there's my wife who suggested we open a shop. I had some redundancy pay from the army. Liz, that's my wife. She'd always been interested in that line, so we bought the shop. And then she left me. Last year.
Well, Mr. Lane, we're going to have to hang on to some of this stuff.
I was floundering a bit for a while, as you can imagine.
For the moment.
So then I thought, well, why not give Kay a job? She knows the trade. I don't know what I'd do without her.
Right. We may need another word with Miss Fox.
Well, you can get her at the shop, or at my home. That's Greville House in Floodfury Road, number 84.
She lives with you?
Yeah, she was kicked out of her own flat a couple of months ago. I offered her a room.
I met a guy down the pub. Said he wanted this stuff flogged.
Describe him.
What?
The guy in the pub.
Small. Short. Blonde.
Blonde.
Fair, you know?
What was he wearing?
Jeans. And a jacket.
Short, blonde guy in jeans and a jacket. Well, he should be easy to find. You're not helping yourself. You flogged the jewellery.
I didn't nick any jewellery.
You set it down the arcade?
How did you know I was going to be there?
We only have to go back and ask round.
I never got inside the arcade. I'd only just arrived when you arrested me. I was with a mate this morning. Just left his place, went round the arcade and ran into you.
I'm reliably informed that you were seen there earlier.
I couldn't have been, because I wasn't there. I was with my mate, Norrie Miller. You ask him. He lives at 54 Galata Street.
That's unique.
Yeah, I can imagine.
60s are very big.
I'm DC Carver, Sun Hill.
Yeah, I saw you chasing that bloke through here this morning.
So you saw the man we arrested earlier?
The big lad. I thought he was going to get violent. Not usually so exciting round here.
I'm trying to find out if he was flogging anything.
Flogging what?
Jewellery.
What was it? Knocked off?
So he didn't approach you?
No.
Did you notice him hanging around?
First time I saw him was when he come running in here with you after him.
So you didn't see him earlier?
No.
You wanted to speak to me.
Have you talked to Norrie?
Not yet.
I've been fitted up.
Mr. Murray, you were caught red-handed with the stolen gear.
It was Kay fitted me up.
Kay Fox?
She told you I was at the arcade, didn't she? I was supposed to be there. But I was with Norrie this morning, like I told you. I got there late.
What exactly are you saying, man?
Kay planned the whole thing.
Should have known it wasn't kosher last night. Kay said she'd leave the alarm off.
So the burglary was Kay's idea?
She told me what stuff to take, you know, the best stuff. And then to get around the arcade and sell it this morning, before the place got too busy, around 11. But like I say, I lost track of time. Why'd she grass me up?
You tell us.
She's changed. She's got harder.
How long have you known Kay Fox?
About 4 years. She used to hang about with some people I knew from home, around Dalston way. I was robbing a few houses at the time. Done a big one up Islington. I got some nice bits and pieces. She took them and sold them on.
You had a relationship with her?
I don't know.
You don't know?
You never know what Kay's thinking. I mean, when she let me, not as often as I'd have liked. If I'd robbed some decent stuff, she'd, you know, as a reward kind of thing. I used to think about her all the time when I was inside. She never visited or anything, but I couldn't stop thinking about her.
When did you start seeing her again?
I got out about a month ago. Prison people found me a bed set down this way. Went out for a walk one day and there she was. Couldn't believe it. She was a bit strange at first, but after a while she was nice and, you know.
So when did Kay suggest that you break into the shop?
Last week. She said she'd had enough.
Enough of what?
Everything. Especially that Paul bloke that she lives with. You seen that bruise in her face?
Paul Layton did that.
Kay said he gets a bit funny with her sometimes. He fancies her. Who wouldn't? But she doesn't fancy him. After he hit her, she decided she'd had enough.
Why exactly did he hit her?
I don't know. He was in the army. Kay said he was in Bosnia. I suppose that's enough to do anybody's head in. Then his wife left him. I can't believe she'd stitch me up.
So you think she stole the jewellery using a burglary as a cover?
Well, Len's reaction is credible enough. She's a cool customer. She must have known it implicated once he realised he'd been stitched up.
So she only has to deny it and then it's his word against hers?
Well, the only weakness in her story is that she claims that he was at the arcade when he wasn't. There's always something to trip up the best laid plans.
If she's as clever as you're making out, she'll be moving to cover her tracks.
Well, she'll have to move pretty sharpish, especially if Len's alibi stands up.
You looking for Norrie?
That's right.
He's not in. I told ya.
Do you know when he'll be back?
What are you, the law? Yeah, you look like the law.
Is that Mr. Miller?
I don't know.
Mr. Miller?
Who wants to know?
DC Carver, Sunhill. Could I have a word, please?
What about?
Well, perhaps we should go inside.
Oh, no. I want a witness.
Could you tell me where you were this morning?
I was here.
He was here.
Till what time?
All morning.
He never went out.
Excuse me, could you just get on with your bike? Thank you. Were you alone?
Probably.
Mr. Miller, you're not being accused of anything.
I haven't done anything.
No one's saying you have. Is Mr. Leonard Murray a friend of yours?
He might be.
Have you seen him recently?
So this is about Len?
When was the last time that you saw him?
Well, I was probably with Len for a while this morning.
Probably?
Possibly.
Until what time?
Till about one.
1 o'clock?
Or later, maybe.
So when did he leave your house?
It's difficult to say. I mean, you lose track of time, you know?
So Norrie's inconclusive.
Norrie doesn't know up from down. Len was probably with him this morning. I can't really say until what time.
OK, thanks, Jim. Yeah, the shop's owned by Mr. Paul Layton, who may or may not be involved with Kay. Whether he is or not, she's taking him for a mug.
Smart round here, isn't it? Nice to see this area get a new lease of life.
Jim Carver thinks it's been invaded by yuppies.
We can't stand in the way of progress.
Oh, hello again.
This is DC Proctor. I'm looking for Miss Fox.
She went out a little while ago.
When are you expecting her back?
Not sure where she's gone. Is it important?
We just need to clarify a few...
Hello. Sorry it took so long, Paul.
Miss Fox, this is DC Proctor. I wonder if we can have a word.
Of course. Come through to the back.
I'll be in the stockroom if you need me.
Did Len say anything about the jewellery?
He claims not to know anything about it.
I expect he got rid of it. I hear you've been talking to the stallholders at the arcade.
That's right. But he didn't sell the jewellery down there.
No one down there would tell you if he had. It's not every day something like that falls into your lap.
Can you confirm for us what time you were down the arcade this morning?
About 11.
And you say you saw Len there?
Yeah.
What was he doing?
Wandering around.
If I was to say to you that Len claims that he wasn't at the arcade until 12, and that he was with someone until just before that time, how would you explain that?
He's lying.
Miss Fox, were you actually down the arcade this morning?
Of course. Otherwise, how would I have seen Len?
Maybe you just expected him to be there. I'm arresting you on suspicion of theft.
You do not have to say anything, but it may harm your defence if you do not mention when questioned something which you later rely on in court.
What's going on?
Anything you do say may be given in evidence.
It's all right, Paul. It's a misunderstanding.
You're arresting Kay. You've got the man who did it.
Of course, she's too clever to have hidden anything in her room.
Oh, we ought to have a look.
She's intriguing, isn't she?
You think so?
She uses men, but she doesn't like them. Sex doesn't mean anything to her.
Sarge?
I had a message from Ron Burgess. Apparently he did buy one of the pieces of stolen jewellery. Now, he's changed his story since this morning.
It was Ron Burgess.
Oh, he's one of the traders I spoke to down at the arcade. He denied ever having seen Len.
Right, we need to check that out. Let's see what Miss Fox has to say first.
Let me guess. Len told you that the break-in was my idea.
Why would he say a thing like that?
This is his revenge. If I had planned the break-in, I wouldn't have told him to get rid of the stuff down at the arcade. He wouldn't have got a good price for it there.
You say you saw Len down at the arcade about 11-ish. We've spoken to someone who claims to have been with him till nearly 12.
That wouldn't be Norrie Miller, would it? Len doesn't know anyone else around this way. And if you've spoken to Norrie, you'll know what he's like. He'll say anything if he thinks it'll help Len.
Len said you used to sell the stuff that he burgled.
Men become mean when they don't get their own way. Len just wants to hurt me.
But you knew he was a burglar when you were going out with him.
I didn't ask too many questions about what he did. I often think that the less we know about people, the better. Don't you?
Mr. Burgess!
Come on up.
I'm D.S. Daly, Sun Hill. I think you've already met my colleague, D.C. Carver.
That's right. I've been out, I'm afraid. Do you want some tea?
Not for us, thanks.
Take a pew. It was only after you'd gone, I thought, maybe I had seen that man you arrested before. He'd been in there about an hour before you turned up. It's Sir Halsey. If you'd been more specific, I'd have clicked right away.
Did he say where he got it from?
No, and I didn't ask him. I know now it came from Paul Layton's shop.
How do you know that?
Word soon got around about the break-in at Paul's shop, and I rang and spoke to Kay.
You know Kay Fox?
Oh, yes. And I could not have called you people when I found out where that had come from. Kay tells me it was her boyfriend that did the shop. Is that right?
Yeah. About what time did he turn up at the arcade?
About 11.
Mr. Burgess, withholding information from the police is a very serious matter.
Oh, yeah, I know. And that's why I'm telling you about this. It's only right.
You know I was down the arcade this morning. I saw Len arrive. It would be about 12 o'clock.
He was definitely in there earlier. Maybe he left and came back.
Maybe. So when did you speak to Kay Fox?
A little while ago.
She's a good friend of yours, is she?
Known her since she first arrived. She came off the boat from Ireland with nothing. I'm glad she's making something of her life.
You're fond of her. You like to help her out.
What kind of world would it be if we didn't help each other out?
Do you know Paul Layton?
He gets to know everyone in the business.
He's been good to Kay. He's given her a job, somewhere to live.
Yeah, I suppose so.
It's a shame he got turned over. His wife left him, I hear.
Not surprising.
No.
His time in the army knocked him a bit doolally.
It's lucky he found an attractive girl like Kay.
They don't have that kind of relationship. Kay's too independent to let any man trap her.
Well, thanks for your information, Mr. Burgess.
That's well.
Oh, I take it you'll have no problem standing up in court saying that Len sold you this.
Oh, you think it'll come to court? You found the rest of the stuff on him, did you? If I was his solicitor, I'd advise him to plead guilty.
Except that we haven't recovered the rest of the jewellery.
He only showed me the one piece.
I wonder what happened to the rest of it.
Who knows?
Thank you.
Have you got everything?
Yes, thanks. I just want you to know, I don't blame you for this. You're only doing your job. Bye now.
So she's going to get away with it.
You win some, you lose some.
It's Leighton I feel sorry for. He takes her in, he gives her a job, and she steals from him.
Yeah, Burgess obviously tipped her off that we were asking questions.
Well, I can guess what she promised him to plug the gap in her story.
I don't think she needed to promise him anything. He's fond of her. Oh, come on, look, he's 60 if he's a day.
Well, it's tradition at Sun Hill for the new boy to buy his colleagues a drink.
Oh, that's funny. My old Nick, it was the other way round.
I'll just get my coat. You come in for one, Jim?
Yeah, I think I will.
Sharp lad, Tom.
Yeah?
Don't you like him?
No reason not to. I can't wait to see what Rod Skates will make of him, though.
Here. She's in here.
I knew she was dead.
Can you give us your name, sir?
Paul Leighton.
What happened?
I went out. I was halfway down the street before I realised I'd forgotten my wallet.
When was this?
It was a short while ago. I came back, walked in, and she had that bag in her hand and her jacket on. She was about to leave.
What's the name of the young woman?
Kay. Kay Fox. She was angry with me.
Angry about what?
She was talking about leaving last week. Everybody leaves me. It's unfair. I hit her. I'm so ashamed. I get unreasonable. I apologize, of course. I thought she'd forgiven me. I begged her not to go. I pulled the bag away from her. She'd stolen the stuff. Just like the detective said. The silly thing is, I would have given the jewelry to her if she'd asked me. I'd have given her anything.